attached to every divine assignment will be a predicament. Joseph is a good man. Listen at this. Joseph is preparing to be able to bring his wife home. Joseph is doing all that he needs to do to make preparation, to make sure he can take care of his wife. And as he's doing all of this, now all of a sudden, like getting a taste slapped out of your mouth, talking about you're pregnant, there's a predicament, Lord. Lord have mercy. All I'm trying to tell you is it's inexplainable. And some things will happen in our life that's unexplainable. Some things, as we just obeying God and doing what we're supposed to do, you're not going to be able to figure it out. You're not going to be able to say it happened because of this or happened because of that, but you got to be reminded that I'm on assignment. Somebody say, I'm on assignment. When you're on assignment, some things will jump off. Attached to every divine assignment must be, look at this, a capacity to do what is right. And listen, every divine assignment will be based upon my capacity to be able to do what is right. God will be able to give me something that I'm able to handle. Matthew 1:19 says, and her husband Joseph, look at this, being a just man and unwilling to put her to shame, resolved to divorce her quietly. Joseph was a just man. In other words, God didn't pick anyone that was just simply living in any kind of way. He was not just picking anybody, some old just average person just going to running the mill, brother. But no, this individual, the Bible says, was a just man. Can you imagine Joseph? Come on, remove yourself. You know the end of the story, and you've heard it so long, but remove yourself from knowing the end of the story and imagine if you were Joseph. The way you've been waiting all this time to marry this individual, and now all of a sudden she's talking about she's pregnant. Imagine his emotions. Imagine his hurt. Imagine the disappointment. Imagine what's going on in his mind and in his heart. But God is telling Joseph, I let you go through it because I know your capacity. Lord, Lord have mercy. I know what you can handle. I know what you can deal with. And that's why I'm letting you go through it. Attached to every divine assignment. He didn't know. Things were foggy. Attached to every divine assignment, God provides clear instructions. This is what God helps us. God helps us here because Joseph didn't know what was going on. Mary didn't know what was going on. But when I'm obeying God and following God for real, though, he gives me clear instructions. Attached to every divine assignment should be a level of unwavering commitment. It should be a level of unwavering commitment. God, first of all, God tells him to stop fearing. So obviously he's scared. So he tells him not to fear. Don't be afraid to step outside of yourself. Everything in you telling you to get rid of her. But don't be afraid to trust me. Don't be afraid to have some unwavering commitment. Even when everybody around you probably is telling you, oh, you stupid. Oh, I can't believe you doing that. I can't believe you believe that. I can't believe you said that. You got to have some unwavering commitment to what God has said. All of my senses are telling me no. Everything about life is telling me that I'm a fool. Everything about what my situation is telling me not to do this. But because God said to do it, I'm going to have some unwavering commitment to what God has said. Look at attached to every divine assignment should be a level of unconditional compliance. What am I saying? I'm saying that are you and I to the place and the posture with God? Are we so aligned to God that I can be heading in a direction, make up in my mind that I'm going to do this, make up in my mind this is what I'm going to do, but God tells me not to and I stop on a dime? Look at Joseph being so, he gonna comply with God and with everything in his body is screaming no. He still follows God. Let me. On behalf of everyone at Truth and Love Ministries, we want to thank you for joining us for our virtual worship experience. We want to thank you for your likes and your shares, your comments and your emojis. But we also want to invite you to partner with us as we continue to be the hands and the feet of the Lord Jesus Christ.
You do know that he told us that we ought to feed the hungry, we ought to clothe the naked, and we ought to be the church. And you can help us to continue to do just that through your generosity. And there are three easy, safe, and secure ways that you can do just that. You can text the word TILJAX, one word, TILJAX, to the number 77977. You can go to our website, www.truthandlove.tv, or you can go to the Apple Store or the Google Play Store, search for Truth and Love JAX, download our app, and you can give that way. We thank you for your participation. We thank you for your generosity, and we love you, and we'll see you next time. Here comes the church. God bless you.